Okay, so guess I'll try out the new weather. It's from the new patch. So I'll just go a single event, do some time trial, keep it easy. I believe there's a new track in Canada. I'm not too sure. Let me check. Yeah, Sinclair Pass. There's a loop. Okay, so just give this a try. Time of day, I'll keep it noon. Time compression, sure. Cloud cover, cloudy, overcast, stormy. Keep it clear. Dry, light precipitation. Oh wow, they actually show you the environmental settings now. Heavy, dynamic, dry, light. I'm gonna go dynamic. See, choose how much. Yeah, I'm gonna try dynamic. See how that is. That was event settings, I believe. Oh, face offs is off. Random. Okay, sounds good. So I'll play. I'm gonna go with my dream car, pretty much. So that is the Ferrari. Where is it? There it is, Ferrari 458. Yeah, I'll stick with a stock color. I could go white or black. No, I'll stick with stock. And I'll switch between the different views, see how it looks. And I mean, already it's pretty darn impressive. So give this a try. And see what it looks like. So far there's nothing in here. It's just dry. There's some weird transition in the road. I'm not sure if that's just part of the map. And I'll start it off. So right now there is no rain. Seems like dynamic means that it will change over time. I guess for now I'm just gonna go into cockpit view and just drive around. I'm gonna try not to crash just because I do want to take a look at the car without the crash. I've tried out on phone, but it will just stop at any time you press the touchpad, and you can just take in the view. This track, the turns, they're not tough, but they're frequent. So for now, there is nothing happening. Let's switch back to the other view. This car, I love this car. It doesn't drift very well, but I just love the car looks. Dream cars always have them. Oh no! Damn it. Any damage? I'm still scratching. So now it's starting to rain. Ah, okay, now it's starting to rain. I'm gonna go into the here. So the faster I go, you'll notice the rain droplets. The rain droplets will start to move depending on which direction that the force of the car is pushing it. So as I turn, it'll go left and right, and if I go forward, it'll push backwards. As I stop, it'll just push forward. Holy shit. And the road conditions do change, so what I'm actually going to do is... That is a lot of turns. Do photo mode and just take a look at the car during photo mode. Let me get into the forested area, and then I'm just gonna pause it there. Let me go back out again, take into the rain. Pause it here. And right away I can do whatever the heck I want with the rain. That looks amazing. But I think there should be some water coming out of the tires. I do kind of see it right there. But it just started raining, so it's not really showing all the water yet. Where the wipers are, you can see it's clean. Not gonna bother taking any pictures. I mean, with this thing, there's a lot of tools with this. Move up and down, roll left or right. And then move back. How do I do? All right, and then I could change the camera type. Cycle camera, that's what I want to do. So I could move around the camera while in the cockpit. Okay, so I'm gonna go back and continue until it starts raining even more. Have a look at what the cars look like after that. So what I'm gonna do is change back to cockpit. And continue driving until you get a lot more rain. I did choose it as a dynamic, so I'm ready for the race. Oh, it is separating. So even with the dynamic weather, the ground will change as there's more water across the road. This is running on the new track that has been added to free with the 1.08 update for Driveclub. It is a sort of a hefty update. It's 1 point, I think it was just over 1 gigabyte. So here's that too. And as you can see, the clouds are getting darker. The sky is getting darker. The rain has picked up. Pause it, have another look from here. So a lot more rain droplets. Still a little splash. A little, what's it called? Yeah, splashing from the back. Can zoom out a little. I think there should be even more rain. So I'm just gonna continue and see what it looks like. That's really nice though. All right, so I'll continue. Oh, should have stopped it. The wheels are slippery as shit, and stopping does take a lot longer. Can't really tell from the video itself, but the controls definitely. That's getting sunny. So I'm not sure if the rain actually stopped, but the ghosts that you see up above are other people's time. So I'm just going to get through time. Not the purpose of this race, but at least for what I'm doing here, it's a nice addition. It's hard to turn, you have no idea how hard this is. seems like the rain has died down. So it might actually just change it after this. After this lap, if the rain doesn't change, then I will change it to heavy precipitation. See if there's any difference, because the sun is out, and I can't see shit. Crap. It is drying up. One thing that's really nice is the lighting on this. So I'm just gonna stop it and then you can really appreciate the lighting in this game. It looks pretty fantastic. Like right there, just that shot right there. Could do some image processing. Which is similar to the processing tools in GT 5 and 6, but obviously a lot more advanced. Not too sure how to really play with this stuff, so I'm not gonna do too much. Change the shutter speed. Anyways, not the point, but the rain effect does add a really nice. Once I make it to the end of this track, I'm going to change it so that it's not dynamic rain, it is just purely heavy rain. So I'll stop here, I'm going to finish the event, and take a look at the weather effects without any changes. So I'll just end this here.